Hi, I'm Steve Hammes from Drive Time. And this week, I'm test driving the 2014 Jeep Patriot Limited 4x4. Now, just a couple of weeks ago, I test drove the Compass, this vehicle's Jeep sibling. Mechanically, they're pretty much identical. However, this vehicle has a lower starting point of around $17,000. This Jeep Patriot Limited 4x4 stickers for just under $29,000. Now for that price, you get this fairly high quality leather interior seating. There are heated seats. It comes with the older Uconnect system, which is still good, but a little small compared to that beautiful 8.4 inch system that they have in some of their newer models. But the big news this year concerns the addition of this 6-speed PowerTech automatic transmission. Now the CVT transmission is still available, and you need to choose it if you want a trail-rated model.
The Patriot Limited runs with the larger of the two available engines, the 2.4 liter mill that was co-developed with other companies about a decade ago. At 172 horsepower and with dual variable valve timing, the Patriot feels amply energetic, and the new 6-speed works beautifully in smoothing the engine's delivery. But it's the vibration and lack of refined sounds that indicate its age. This 4x4 is rated at 21 mpg city, 27 highway, considerably better numbers than the CVT produces, yet they trail those of the powerhouse 2-liter turbo and the Patriot's strongest competitor, the Ford Escape. Though this tester rolls with the non-trail rated Freedom Drive 1 four-wheel drive system, there is a lock mode to keep both axles receiving power. Freedom Drive 2 comes with skid plates, tow hooks, and a crawl ratio when off-road mode is activated. And after all, the Patriot was designed to imitate the look of the last-gen Cherokee, and its rugged SUV boxiness is part of its charm.
I've been driving the Patriot around for about a week now, and it does everything relatively well. Nothing to write home about, but the engine is powerful enough, it's fuel efficient enough, but it does have trouble competing with some of those newer crossovers, say the Ford Escape and Honda CR-V. So I would suggest if I was interested in one of these, I would definitely go with the trail rated model. That's really what distinguishes the Patriot from all the others.
There are some nice features here, like remote start, adjustable roof rail crossbars, and the Uconnect voice command with Bluetooth. But in general, when you get inside, you find the cheaper plastics and harder touch points that have no place in a vehicle of this price.
The rear seats on the Patriot are actually pretty generous as far as the leg and headroom go. And there is a tab here on the side of the seat that allows you to recline. It does not slide, however. But the big problem is, as you can see, is that you can really only fit two more people back here. That's because this center console travels back to this center seating position with cup holders on the floor.
So here it is. If you're looking for a small, affordable off-roader that can also satisfy as a daily driver, then the Patriot gives you a viable, unique option in the segment. But if you have no interest in hitting the trail, there are other newer models that'll do a better job. MSRP of this Patriot is $28,730. For Drive Time, I'm Steve Hammes.